Good morning, children. Myself Ramesh sir. Now after a very long time, all you will be watching me on video there. Children, you know, due to this corona, this lockdown period, all we are studying on the that is a video that online teaching that. Today I want to discuss with you that food for all. Today we will see something change. You know, so far up till now, whatever I have sent you video that all that video that it was made on the paper. And I think that on the paper teaching and you will also that studying, it is very difficult, but today you will enjoy something different. That what small board I have brought, one my friend, that today's topic I will, that is, I want to explain on the board that, and definitely all you will enjoy, that is on the board that definitely I will also feel better to teach on the board. In details we will see that, and definitely every concepts, your doubts, terms, I will try to explain on the board that all you will enjoy that. Have a good day. Now you see that what exact that food for all, these lessons I am going to teach you that. Now see that I have written that food for all that. See that food for all, which lessons I have started yesterday that. And yesterday we have seen that food for all, that is the first topic, it was the agriculture, different types of the agriculture, and that is the agricultural work, traditional agriculture, and that is seasons for the agriculture. In the seasons for the agriculture we studied, that is there were the two types of the seasons are there. One is the rabi season and the kharif season. And what is agriculture? That also a lot of giving the examples I try to explain you that. And what was the traditional agriculture? That also I had explained that. Today I want to discuss you to that is the improved methods of the agriculture. What is meaning of the improved methods of agriculture? And what is the agriculture that all you have understood that? And what is the relation between food and the agriculture? You know that food is grown in the farm, and that farming means that is the agriculture. And you know that food is very important. If you don't have the food, no any living things can survive that. And food is grown in the agriculture. Now see that when we study any topics, that time we have to study that exact that what we will, that is a study under that topics that. Improved methods of agriculture means that what are the improved methods of the agriculture? That in the improved methods of the agriculture, you will study about the improved seeds. What is mean by improved seeds? I will explain that. First, you see this flow chart. Modern methods of the irrigation. What are the modern methods of irrigation? Modern methods of irrigation, there are the two types of them. That is irrigation, that is the drip irrigation and the sprinkler irrigation. What is mean by drip? What is mean by sprinkler? I will explain that. What is meant by irrigation? That also you have to understand. What is meant by irrigation? That yesterday I explained that. Irrigation, it means that is a with the water that. The farming is being done with the water. That farming is called as a irrigated. Now you see that also I will explain. Wait one. That is a fertilizer. Fertilizer playing a very important role. This is a, you know, it is a boost it gives to the plants. And due to the fertilizer, the plants grow so rapidly, fastly. What happens with the fertilizer, what are the types of the fertilizer, that also you will explain, that I will explain. Wait for, now that there are the two types of the fertilizer, is the chemical fertilizer and second is the natural fertilizer. What is the role of chemical fertilizer and what is the role of the natural fertilizer, that also I will explain that with that. That overall this is a flow chart from this topic, today's lecture you will study all these terms, one by one we will see that. Now. See that now you have to write all these terms and you have to draw also this flow chart. Means that is easy, you will understand that. When you see that, when you close your eyes there, when we discuss that is improved methods of the agriculture, that all the terms you should come in front of your eyes that. Improved seeds, that is a modern method of irrigation, fertilizer, there are the two types of the fertilizer, that are the chemical fertilizer and the natural fertilizer, irrigation methods are the two methods are there, that is a drip irrigation method and is the sprinkle irrigation. And what are the improved seeds that I will explain. Now you write it there. Now see that, what are the improved seeds? First we have to try to understand what is the improved seeds. see the children that actually what this agriculture, or you are the if you have the background of the agriculture, you know that when the farmers he put the seeds in the form that earlier actually what happened many that is a long year back that the farmer doing the farming, he was keeping some seeds. Whatever he gets the seeds that is from the harvesting, he that keeps the seeds for the next year crops that. And that the same seeds he used to put in the form. And that seeds, it was not that powerful, that is improved. Might be that seeds may be damaged and that time we won't get that is that much, that is yield that. And that today if you see that, we have the in the market improved seeds are there. Now today that is the farmer, he is not keeping any seeds that is this year, that is harvesting that. Everything is selling and that is using that. And when in the season, that is a rabi season or kharif season, it comes there. And that time, when he put the seeds in the form, that time he purchasing the seeds from the market. Because he is getting the improved seed. Now we have the many research laboratories are there. And now generally the improved seeds are developed through the research, that is. Now we have the research methodology is there. Different universities you have there. In Nanded near Parbhani Agriculture University, there the scientists, they research the seeds are there. And that seeds if you put in the soil and definitely we will get them that is a more that is a yield and that is a quality is also we will get the good quality and that we can earn the more money also in the small form also we will get the more yield that more crops we will get that. That's why we use to the improved seeds are there. Improved seeds are give that is a higher yield. Yield means that after harvesting, whatever we get the crops there, whatever we get the grains there, and that production, yield means what that productions. And that production is a bigger production due to the improved seed there. Third point is there, these seeds are resistant to pest attack. Generally, when we put the seeds in the soil that, after when that this plant is grow there and that is rapidly and that time if you see that plants easily not be attacked by the pest or any that is insecticides it will not fall on it that easily it can be controlled it himself that is the crops can be that is a fight with the pest attack there. And that is the fourth point, it is that it helps in the early, that is the harvest. Earlier actually what happened, the crops is also every, that is a lifespan of the crop is a different there. If you see that jawar crops, it is there, it lifespan, that is a 4 to 5 months, that is a 4 to 5 months are there. Some that is a moong, udadal, this that is a pulses are there, 3 to 4 months it comes there. Again, if you see some vegetables are there, tomatoes are there, you know that bitter gourd is there. That brinjals are there, all these that vegetables it comes to only the 1.5 is a 1.5 month to that is the 2 months it comes there like that. Every crop that is a lifespan it is a different it is a duration is different that. But generally the improved seeds actually it gets that is a early harvest that means the very that is a less time that it grows and that is a maturity that it complete grows and we get that crops very easily and very fastly. And they give that is high yield even with the low irrigation. That is, when we don't have the water, more water is if we not have that. That time also, these seeds it can grow on its own. Then these are the benefits, advantage of the improved seeds, and that is very important. That. Now, children, you see that when we got the that is a freedom, that is a our India got the freedom. That time, if you see that. That time if you see that, 1947 we have got the freedom. That time, our population, it was very less population over there. That time I think that is a 36 crore, that this much population it was there. And that time, we were not getting the food also to eat that. And that time we didn't use any improved seed, nothing it was there. Now see that whatever the land it was there, land it was supposed to be this much land it was there. And that is 36 crore it is there. But now, in 2020 and that is the 1947, if you see that, land it is the same. Population it is there, 136 crore. Still that is we are getting the everyone's food. And now today that is exporting the food grains to the other countries. It means what? What is this? Behind it that is the improved seeds are there. now we have started, that is a seeds, improved seed, it means what? That is a, we have, that is a developed the seeds, the, our scientists studied on it there. And you know that, that some, that is a genetical traits are there, that has been changed. When you go in the higher standard, no? That you will study, that is a more about it. Here I will show, many students might be confused, sir, what are the seeds, we don't know. Are seeds, it means what? That seed, it means that is a, you know that, you know, grains are there, pulses are there, cereals are there, that is a seeds. Now I will show you that again, somebody that might be, now see, this is a jawar. Huh? This is a jawar, that is jawar, this is seeds. This is a quality seeds are there, if you put in the soil, then it will grow. That it is, this is improved seeds are there. So definitely, you see that, before going to sow the seed, that time we should see that, whether the seeds are the damaged or not, we should see that, and the seeds are very good quality, then we will get the good quality crop there. Now see, that is a, some other, that is a, I know that, you know, this is the chana, the good quality chana, it is there. We have to see that, and the improved seed is there, in the laboratory, all the seeds are checked, everything, and the seeds, you know that some changes, they done that. That is a, some pesticides or any, that is a chemicals, it is used there, and the seeds are so healthy there. And such seeds, when we put in the soil, we will get the more crop, and that is the yield. And that is the uses of the improved seed. I think all you have understood that, what are the improved seeds. Such improved seeds, if you put in the soil, then we get the more crops and more, that is the yield. And in this way, now we will start that. Now we will see the next topic. Children, now you see that I have written on the board, that is the modern methods of the irrigation. This is the second topic. First topic we studied the improved seeds. Second topic, that is the modern method of irrigation. What is the modern method, sir? You know, sir, earlier, actually we used to give the water. Earlier there were no any methods of to provide the water. Only one method it was there, that is a canal method, or that is a, we know that is a moat method. Yesterday we see, that is a, I shown that how the water it was giving to the plants, how the water it was taking from the, that is the way. But yesterday, I think I had shown or not, actually you know that, this is your, see the textbook is there. Now see this textbook, that is a, how the water is taken out, that is a, from the well, that. This is the way the water it was giving to the plants are there. That is the moat water, that is the moat. That is a huge leather bag it was there, what is the moat? Yesterday I explained that, drawn with the help of the oxen, it was used to that. And in this way the water it was giving to the plants or the crops are there. Now you see that. Now what is the, you know that agriculture work, it was the plowing. This is a traditional method, it was the agriculture working, that is a, you know, plowing. Today we have so modern method is there. We, that is a plow, that is a land with the help of the tractor, that many. But still this some way, you know that more than 50% of the farmers, they are doing only the traditional way that. But when we go in the, you know that, in the other area that, in Pachim Maharashtra, definitely there the farming way, you know, the modern method it was there. Now these things, I had shown you that yesterday, that now you see that in this way the water it was going and giving to the plants. Now you see that the modern methods of the irrigation, it means the irrigation, it means that is the availability of the water. That the water, if you have the availability of the water. But in that, you know, in India that irrigation it was very less, that is a farming there, compared to the other countries are there. In India, in Marathwada, Nanded is in the Marathwada. In Marathwada is the very, that is the irrigation, it is very less irrigation there. In Nanded district, if you see that, this 2-3, that is areas, that is a talukas, more irrigation is there. But more than 50%, they don't have irrigation. Irrigation, it means that is a, they have the water facilities are there. It means they have the well, they have the river, or the bore wells are there. In this way, that is that they use the water to the plants. Means that is that there are the two ways are there, drip irrigation and the sprinkle irrigation. You know, the questions will arise then, sir, why we have that is a started with the drip irrigation and the sprinkle irrigation. It means what, the earlier, whatever, in what way we are giving the supply to the water to the plants. In that time actually what happened, we don't have any, that is that generally we giving the water to the plants through the canal, and that time the more water it was wasting, that is that water it was wasting that time. But due to, through this method, the water it can be saved. That is, the water can save. Water can save. Means the water can be saved. Exactly what is mean by the drip irrigation and what is mean by the sprinkle irrigation. Now, when I have the photo is there, I will show you that in your textbook there. Sprinkle irrigation. what happens to sprinkle irrigation? You are seeing that sprinkle irrigation. If you have the textbook at home, you go through the read and all these topics. Sprinkle irrigation images, that is the pipes are there and the two wells are there, and through that or everything, that is it falls the rain, that is all the crops. I mean, this one supposed to be, I will show you that. Supposed to be, this is a pipe. Okay. Here the pipe, it is the one that the standing pipe, it is there. Here it is one standing pipe, it is there. Now the water, it is coming from through here. Okay. Now here the crops are there. Here the crops are there. And now the water is falling like this. This much area it is covered there. The water is falling, that is a sprinkler, water is a sprinkler. Now, here are the falling water. This is a sprinkler. It means that is the water is sprinkled and it falls on the plants, and this way the water, it will not be wasted. This is a sprinkler maker. This is a sprinkler maker. Understood that? And second method is the drip irrigation method. What is drip irrigation method? Drip irrigation method means in the form that wherever it's supposed to be, here the one plant is there. And through their plants, that is near the bottom, their plants, one pipeline goes there. Okay? And where the plant is, that is growing, that is standing, there only some of these pipes are, the holes are there. Small holes are there. And the water, it will be supplied there only. Here the water, it will come and falls at the root, at the bottom of the stem. The here only, that is the water, it will fall. It means that water, it will not go anywhere there. And here only, that is the bottom of the plant, the water it will supply, means the water wasting will not be there. Only the water will get, that plant will be, and plant will be good. Means the water can save them. And this is called as the drip irrigation. In this way, in the drip irrigation, why these modern methods are there, you know that. And what are the sources of the water there? Many sources are there. Now we have, you know that somebody that is farming is near the, that is a river, bank of the river. Some that farming is near the lake there. Means the sources of water, the farmers, they can get the water from the lake, they can get from the pond, they can get from the river also. River, lake, dam. That is a pond also. Now, and somebody's, they have the well. These are the sources of irrigation. Means the somebody's, they get the water from the river. Okay. Somebody's, they get the water from the lake. Somebody's, they have get the water. They will get the water from the dam. And somebody's, they get the water from the pond, small and big pond. And somebody's, they have the well. They get the well. That is, they get the water from the well. And mostly now we see generally, that is everyone has a bore well. What? Bore well facility is there, and they get the water from the bore. Now you know that Punjab state, if you see that, in the Punjab, if you find that is, you know that number of the bore wells, that is in the Punjab, that the drawbacks also there. When you go in the higher standard, that time you will study that bore well is also, it is very, because we are doing the modern methods, but it is a adverse effect on the nature. It is falling on the adverse effect on the nature also. That also I will explain later on. But you have to study. Now the two points are there: modern method of the irrigations, what is the drip irrigation, and what is the sprinkle irrigation. The two points you have to study and keep in mind that. And you know that at the result, that is a loss of water, it will be, that is a less there. And you know that among the modern method of irrigation required the amount of water drips only near the roots of the plants. And the drip irrigation, whereas the sprinkle irrigation, the different sizes are used to spray the water and the plants sprinkle, that is the water sprinkle on the plants. In this way, you have studied the root seeds, and second topic, it is the modern method of the irrigation. Next topic, I will teach you that is a fertilizer. First, see that fertilizer. Fertilizer is a natural or chemical substances. Right on. That is put on land or the soil to make the plants grow better. And used to make soil more fertile. Generally, the fertilizers are added to the soil to increase the productivity Now you understood. Everyone should write this definition. Fertilizer, this is a new concept for you, that you might have heard this fertilizer. Now generally the farmers, if they use the fertilizer, they will get the more yield, otherwise no. But the fertilizer, it has the drawbacks are there, some benefits are there, advantage and the drawbacks, that is the disadvantages are there, that I will explain. First you write, what is fertilizer? Fertilizer, it is a natural or chemical substance. It means that fertilizer, there are the two types of fertilizers are there, natural fertilizer are the chemical fertilizer, chemical substances. That is put in the land, that is on the land or the soil. What the to make the plants grow better? Means that due to the fertilizer, by adding the fertilizer, the plants can grow fast, that rapidly that. And that is used to make the soil more fertile and it will get the more yield also. The fertilizers are added to the soil to increase the productivity. That is the way you have to keep in mind that. Now you see that fertilizers, I am saying that here, you are studying that. The fertilizers are the two types of the fertilizers are there. What are the names? One is the natural fertilizer and second is the chemical fertilizer. Understand? These names you have to keep in mind. What is meant by natural fertilizer and what is meant by the chemical fertilizer? Now have you heard that natural fertilizer and chemical fertilizer? And think over it that and give me answer that. Now see that manure, natural fertilizer is the manure, that is the green waste and that is a cow dung or that is the animal dung. Means that these things are used in the natural fertilizer. You know the natural fertilizer is a very important, that is a, it is a nutritious to the plant that. Now today we are using, that is a, whatever we are getting the crops, that is a, you know, grains, pulses, the everything which is grown in the chemical fertilizer. And there are the drawbacks of the... chemical fertilizer, example, we can say that is a, you know that? Urea, that is NPK, these are the names of the chemical fertilizers. Urea, it is a nitrogenous fertilizer. NPK, it is a nitrogen, phosphorus and the potash. Chemical, it is prepared that. Chemical fertilizer, it is made by the chemical, it is made then. And you know that we can get the more crops, but actually as well as that is the advantages, as well as the many the drawbacks are there. When we use the more fertilizer, it results that our farm, that is, it will be unfertile. That is, you know that, if that is a quality, it will be decreased. That is, a farm quality, it will be decreased there. And one day it will come that nothing it will grow in that field or in that farm there. But natural fertilizer, if you use that, definitely it is very useful there. What is manure or the compost? We can make the manure at home also, whatever the garbage it comes from your house there. In the garbage is also, there are the two types of the garbage are there, decomposable and non-decomposable. Which the decomposable, that is the things comes, that is vegetable peels, all these things, paper, and from it, that is the, we can make the manure. And the green waste, it means that in the form, that is the, whatever the residues of the plants it comes, and from that, that is a fertilizer, that manure, it can be made that. And the animal dung is also, from all these, it is a use, that is a organic fertilizer. It is also called as a organic fertilizer. Organic. In this way, that is a fertilizer, it is a very useful. This organic fertilizer, if you use that, definitely whatever from that, you know, the, after using that, you will get the crops, that it would be so, that is nutritious and no any side effects. But the chemical fertilizer, if you use that, definitely you will get the more drawbacks are there. And actually what upon artificial, that chemical fertilizer is also called as the man-made fertilizer or the artificial fertilizer. Now you will say, children, that sir, if the chemical fertilizer is the harmful, then why should we use that chemical fertilizer? Because the chemical fertilizer, it is also, you know that one part, if you don't use a chemical fertilizer, we don't get that is a, you know, plenty of the food, that is a more yield, we will not get that. That example I've given you, know that when we got the freedom that time, you know that we were not using any of the chemical fertilizer. This is a drawback there, you know that green revolution, it comes in the 1970, that time. Dr. Swaminathan, that is a, he, that is a, you know that, it, every that credit it goes for the Dr. Swaminathan, that is a, he brought, that is a green revolution. And that time, from that year, we have started to use the chemical fertilizer. Because the chemical fertilizer used for the quicker growth and the higher yields we get there. And that is, and the traditional agriculture, the organic manures are used for compost, we use that. For that purpose, we were using that. And you know that if you have any difficulty, that again, I will be explained in the, when while I will teach you in the class, that time I will explain. One point I have forward to that, the variety of the some names, that is a variety of the seeds, I will give you that, you write that variety of the seeds, you know, improved seeds, that I said that, what are the improved seeds in the market, we know that, Jawar, it is a, that is our cereals are there. The names of the, that is, I will give that improved seeds, that is a improved seeds. Improved seed, that is a Jawar. Now you write, that is a C5, that is a H4. It means this is a Jawar, that is improved seeds. We have, after researching, we have made these seeds, and that seeds name it is there. C5H4, this is a Phule Yashoda. Phule Yashoda. This is also name of the Jawar seeds. And if you use these seeds, definitely you will get the more yield, because these are the improved seeds of the Jawar. This is not the traditional. In Marathi we see that is a, you know that. And in the wheat, in the wheat, if you see that HD, that is a Kudrat, KUDRAT, that is a 5. This is the improved seeds of the wheat. And that is a, one more, that is a Kudrat 9. Kudrat 9 also there. Kudrat, that is a 17 also there. These are the improved seeds are there. If you use that, definitely we will get the more yield there. In rice, if you see there, in the rice, if you have the jasmine rice, this is the improved seeds is there. Basmati rice is also improved. You know that? All you eat the basmati rice there. Basmati, this is also improved there. In this way, many seeds are there. Only for examples, I have written some examples. You keep in mind that. In this way, now I have to, that I want to stop here. And the remaining portions tomorrow, we will see the different, that is how the, you know that we are studying about the agriculture, that yesterday we studied about the agriculture, agriculture work, traditional, that is the farming, and the seasons of the, seasons of the, that is agriculture, that we studied. Today we studied about the modern methods of the agriculture. In the modern method of the agriculture, we studied what are the improved seeds, what are the modern methods of the irrigations, and what are the fertilizers. These three concepts we have studied. And remaining portion, that is, we will see tomorrow. Thank you.